I'm Cycling Savvy instructor John Allen, and to start here, I'm showing a clip that I've used before. Driving a car, I slowed to follow a cyclist when neither of us could see around a curve. The cyclist was completely passive, taking no action to avoid the conflict which would have occurred if I had not slowed. I later rode through the same location on my bicycle with cameras running to demonstrate the CyclingSavvy technique of control and release. Mostly I was able to stay on the shoulder and motorists could overtake safely. Due to the camera's ultra-wide-angle lens, there is sun glare in the video. In reality, the lighting was better than it looks in the video. Nonetheless, I checked occasionally in my rearview mirror to make sure motorists were keeping a safe clearance. As I approached the blind curve, I took a look over my shoulder and into my mirror and adopted a lane control position. You can see in my shadow that I was making a slow signal for the driver approaching from behind. When we could see ahead, I returned to the shoulder, gave a friendly wave, and the motorist passed. There didn't happen to be a big truck approaching this time, but how were we to know? Not all motorists are going to be as conscientious as I was, but as we say in CyclingSavvy courses, the motorists get smarter when we lead the dance.